Prayer for the government, Archbishop Nicholas Duncan Williams.
From thee, true victory is our mission. That your power is not limited to any generation or to any people. First of all, we want to thank you for past victories. We want to give thanks for the things you've done and for the things you prevented in the past. To qualify us to ask for new things. We thank you for deliverance from the Ebola virus and how you spared us as a people, a nation, and a government. And you kept it away from our borders, not because we are better or we're better than our neighbors, but because you chose to show us mercy. For as it is written, I will have mercy on whom I will. For it's not to him that willeth, nor him that runneth, but that God that showeth mercy. Esau have I hated, and Jacob have I loved. That is your discretion, because you are God all by yourself, and you do what pleases you. Once again, we are confronted with another situation, a deadly virus, the coronavirus, taking lives, putting fear in the hearts of the leaders of nations, in families and in communities, cities of the nations of our world. We lift up prayer standing at this time today from the throne room perspective, from where all authority over heaven and earth and the underworld kingdom proceeds. Lifting prayer in that name that is above any other name. For it is written at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue of things visible and invisible in the heavens above the earth and beneath the earth shall acknowledge the Lordship of Christ. For we also recognize that at the mention of the name of Jesus, for whosoever shall call upon the name of Jesus shall be delivered. And so we call upon the name of the Lord on the behalf of the government of Ghana. Pray for divine immunity for our government. Praying, Father, for a stubborn determination, courage to withstand these difficult times, that they will have advanced knowledge and wisdom above their years to skillfully, wisely, and intelligently confront the challenges and the issues that confront this country, its citizens, and the nations of our world. We pray for this government that in their time, the vicious cycle that has prevailed from one government to another government, the bitterness and the unforgiveness, the retaliations, and all the things that has plagued us as a people and a nation over the years will end with this government. that this government will be the first among others that broke that vicious cycle, and that this situation that confronts all of us, telling us that we are all the same, and anybody can die tomorrow, irrespective of who you are, may this create in our government the love that is required for country and for one another and for the citizen, the compassion that is so needed in times like this. Thank you, Father. We pray that you will be their guide and their shield, that there will be no loss of any life in government, that no one in government will be a victim of this virus, that no one in government will be a casualty, that you shall preserve, protect, and empower them with the necessary capabilities, that which is required for them to perform their duty for which you have made them a government under the leadership of the President, Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo. That kingdom come,